Hi, my name is Bruno Adorno. Today, I will be presenting Diki Robotics, a library for robot modeling and control that is based on dual quaternion algebra. Let me start with two questions. Why do we need yet another library for robot modeling and control? Why do we need something entirely based on dual quaternion algebra? Those two questions are intertwined. Dual quaternion algebra and its application to robotics have attracted considerable interest in the last two decades. Dual quaternions have great geometric appeal and easily capture physical phenomena inside an algebraic framework, which is useful for robot modeling and control. Nonetheless, dual quaternion algebra is not as widespread as it could be. Not only because classic matrix algebra on real numbers is very mature and provides the backbone of most robotics textbooks, but also because efficient and easy-to-use computational tools are not abundant and usually are restricted to the particular algebra of quaternions. To bridge this gap between theory and implementation, we introduce Diki Robotics, a library for robot modeling and control employing dual quaternion algebra that is easy to use, intuitive enough to be utilized for self-study and education, and computationally efficient for deployment on real applications. Diki Robotics bridges the gap between the theoretical aspects of dual quaternion algebra and practical implementation. For instance, Diki Robotics has already been used in real platforms, such as cooperative manipulators for surgical applications, mobile manipulators, and humanoids, among several other robotic systems. The library is written in three languages, Python, MATLAB, and C++, all of which share a unified programming style to make the transition from one language to another as smooth as possible, enabling fast prototype-to-release cycles. Furthermore, a great effort has been undertaken to make coding as close as possible to the mathematical notation used on paper. So, it is easy to implement code as soon as one has grasped the mathematical concepts. Before describing Diki Robotics in detail, let me first provide a very brief overview of dual quaternion algebra. In the same way that complex numbers extend real numbers, quaternions extend complex numbers. Going one step further, Clifford introduced dual quaternions, which extend quaternions. Given the imaginary units I, J, and K, which obey their qualities below, the set of quaternions is defined analogously to the set of complex numbers, where we have a real part, which is the term that is not multiplied by any imaginary unit, and an imaginary part that contains terms multiplied by the imaginary units. Dual quaternion algebra has one more special unit, often called dual unit and denoted by epsilon, which is different from zero, but epsilon squared equals zero. Dual quaternions are composed of two quaternions. The one that is not multiplied by the dual unit is called the primary part, and the one multiplied by the dual unit is called the dual part. Therefore, the dual quaternion set is an eight-dimensional manifold that contains real numbers, complex numbers, quaternions, and, of course, dual quaternions. Let's see how we can use Diki Robotics to do simple algebraic operations. First, we define two dual quaternions, A and B. This is how we would do on paper. MATLAB and Python codes are identical and very similar to what we have just done. Note that the imaginary units, I, J, and K, are written with an underscore, whereas the dual unit, epsilon, is written as uppercase E with an underscore. In C++, it's almost the same thing, except that we have to explicitly declare the type of A and B, which is a DQ type, and, of course, we have to use a semicolon. If we want to add, subtract, and multiply dual quaternions. We do it quite naturally in all of those three languages supported by Diki Robotics. We can do it thanks to the operator overloading that all three languages support. The library is based entirely on object-oriented programming. The most basic class that implements all algebraic operations is the DQ class. It implements basic binary operations between two dual quaternions, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and right and left division. It also has several unary operations to calculate the exponential and logarithmic mappings, the inverse of dual quaternions, and also to extract the primary, dual, real, and imaginary parts of a dual quaternion. Unit dual quaternions represent rigid motions. The primary part contains a unit quaternion, which represents a rotation, where phi is the rotation angle around the rotation axis n. In the dual part, p is a pure quaternion that represents the translation. We say that this quaternion is pure because the real part equals zero. In Diki Robotics, it is very easy to define unit dual quaternions because they are just objects of class DQ. For instance, we can define a rotation of pi around the y-axis, which is represented by the imaginary unit j. The position with coordinates x equals 0.1, y equals 0.2, and z equals 0.3 is written as this pure quaternion, in which here we can see that I, j, and k represent the axes x, y, and z, respectively. Finally, we define the unit dual quaternion in a simple way that is really very close to what we do on paper. Several geometric primitives can be naturally written as elements of dual quaternion algebra. For example, a plane can be represented by its normal and an arbitrary point on it. Therefore, the primary part of the dual quaternion contains the normal, whereas the dual part contains the inner product between an arbitrary point on the plane and its normal. Remarkably, this inner product gives us the distance between the plane and the origin of the reference frame. For example, a plane with normal pointing in the positive direction of the y-axis and 1.5 units of distance to the origin of the reference frame is defined like this in Diki Robotics. Likewise, a 3D line, which can be defined by its direction and an arbitrary point on it, is defined as a pure dual quaternion, in which the line direction is the primary part, whereas the dual part contains the cross product between an arbitrary point on the line and the line direction. For example, a line parallel to the y-axis passing through point 100 is defined like this in Diki Robotics. Plot methods are available on Diki Robotics in MATLAB that make visualization a simple task. Those methods are available not only for geometric primitives, but also for robots. But, of course, our main interest is in robot modeling and control. Diki Robotics has classes to easily model serial manipulators, some parallel kinematic chains, especially those associated with cooperative manipulation, mobile bases, including non-holonomic ones, and mobile manipulators. Methods for model composition in the DQ whole body class are especially useful for assembling more complex robots from previous ones. For example, two manipulators can be attached to another serial mechanism and a mobile base, resulting in a two-arm mobile manipulator with a torso. All models implemented in Diki Robotics are obtained using dual quaternion algebra. Now, with the available classes for robot modeling, we can easily implement simple control techniques. Suppose that we want to control the end effector pose of a manipulator robot, denoted by X. A very simple technique is based on this control law, in which U is the control input, J plus is the pseudo-inverse of the Jacobian matrix J, eta is a positive gain that determines the convergence rate, and x tilde is the task error. One way of defining the pose error is to take the difference between the unit dual quaternion that represents the current end effector pose and the unit dual quaternion representing the desired end effector pose. The vec operator maps the dual quaternion coefficients to a vector. We have here code snippets implementing this control law for the three languages supported by DQ Robotics. MATLAB code is almost identical to Python code, and both are very close to C++. When implementing on a real robot, we replace the last line with the command to send the control signal to the robot. The library offers different control laws that make it easier to develop clean code. Also, it is simple to implement sophisticated control laws, such as constraint controllers with different control objectives. For instance, the objective may be to control the end effector pose or a plane attached to it. It can also be to control the center of mass of a humanoid robot. In all cases, the controller structure is the same. For example, when using the DQ Pseudo-Inverse Controller class, which implements the control law that we have just seen, if we decide to control the end effector position instead of the end effector pose, we use a single command to set the new control objective, and the library automatically changes the task vector and its corresponding Jacobian matrix. The class DQ Classic QP Controller implements a classic constraint controller based on a quadratic program. The first term in the objective function enforces the desired closed-loop error dynamics, whereas the second one ensures that the joint's velocities are minimized. We use differential inequalities to enforce constraints on the control inputs. We use those inequalities to perform collision and self-collision avoidance, define forbidden regions in task relaxations, enforce tilting constraints, and avoid joint limits. Those inequalities are found for different geometrical primitives within dual quaternion algebra, using simple primitives like the ones we saw at the beginning of this presentation. To show a flavor of a more complex program, let us consider a simulation using DQ Robotics on MATLAB and VRAP. DQ Robotics offers an interface to VRAP that greatly simplifies their integration, especially for simpler programs. In this simulation, we have a KUKA LBR manipulator with 7 degrees of freedom, a KUKA U-Bot, which is a mobile manipulator composed of a 5 degree of freedom arm mounted on top of a holonomic base. There are 2 cylinders and a wall in the workspace. The goal is for the robots and effectors to track prescribed trajectories while the robots avoid the obstacles. The source of the main program is as simple as that. First, we define the sampling time and the total time for the simulation. There is a loop in which first we retrieve information about where the obstacles are in the workspace. Then, we set the desired end effector's trajectories. This is all the information we need to generate the control inputs. We now compute the control input for the KUKA LBR. This control law is based on the pseudo-inverse of the Jacobian matrix. The control law for the mobile manipulator deals with constraints, so first, we compute the constraints and set the controller inequalities. Now, we can compute the constraint control law. Notice that the method has the same signature as the controller based on the pseudo-inverse of the Jacobian matrix. DQ Robotics internally handles the appropriate controller, as well as the control objective to be fulfilled. This is very convenient, as usually we can easily change controllers without having to change the code. Finally, we send the control signals to VRAP. This is the result of the simulation. The KUKA LBR tracks a periodical trajectory while holding a whiteboard. Meanwhile, the KUKA U-Bot has to draw a circle on the whiteboard while avoiding collisions with the obstacles in the workspace. Here, modeling, control, and general geometrical transformations are done by using dual quaternion algebra. Nonetheless, despite being based on a math-intensive framework, the library is very user-friendly, and complex control algorithms of some fairly complex robots can be implemented using relatively few lines of code. That was just a glimpse of the DQ Robotics features. I invite you to take a look at the library's website, where you will find user-friendly instructions on how to install and use DQ Robotics. Finally, I'd like to thank all our students and collaborators who have been using the library, contributing with suggestions and reporting bugs. Many thanks to all of you!